After finishing the course, write your data management plan. Leo wrote his data management plan and updates it regularly if anything changes.
4 years later,
Leo is presenting his amazing results at a conference. The crowd loves his data. One researcher really wants to collaborate.
Can I use your data?
Leo starts to think about his data management strategy.
Is my data findable, accessible, interoperable, reusable? Is my data fair? Is my data fair? Is my data findable?
After publishing his paper, Leo published his dataset in a well-known data repository. The dataset has a persistent identifier, such as a DOI. He adds metadata to the dataset using a common metadata schema, including keywords that help find his dataset. Thanks to Leo's work on making his data findable, people can easily find Leo's dataset.
My data is findable. Is my data accessible?
As written in his data management plan, Leo published his data in a data repository. Even if the data is sensitive or personal, Leo still shares the metadata. The metadata describes how you get access to the dataset. If this metadata is not sufficient, he also includes a README file or protocol that explains how to access the actual dataset. This way, even if Leo moves or dies, everyone who knows the protocol can still access the data.
My data is accessible. Is my data interoperable?
Leo aims to make it as easy as possible for others to utilize his data and integrate it into their workflows. Drawing from his knowledge of research data management, he predominantly used open formats for his datasets, such as CSV files. In cases where these options are unavailable, he chooses formats that are commonly used and are supported by open software. He documents the file types and folder structures within the datasets, maintains a codebook containing data-level metadata descriptions, and includes a README file that specifies the necessary software for opening the program. This way, all researchers, even those who do not have access to commercial software, know how to open the datasets and integrate them into their workflow. Also, his datasets are machine-readable by programs such as R and Python.
My data is interoperable. Is my data reusable?
When writing his data management plan, first Leo described how he collected and processed the data and keeps track of this. He uses this information to describe the provenance and version of the dataset in the README file. Within his dataset and the metadata, he uses controlled vocabulary common in his field. And if this is not available, he explains his vocabulary in a codebook that is published with the dataset. Leo discussed with his supervisor, Mona, what people were allowed to do with his data after he published his papers. Can they just copy the data? Together, they decided to add a Creative Commons license to most of the datasets. For the datasets that contain personal or sensitive data, they explained the usage rights in a legal document, such as a data transfer agreement. This way, researchers that find the dataset, even those from a different field, understand if the data is collected and processed in a way so they can reuse the data for their research. With the help of the license and the relevant legal documents, the researchers know what they can and cannot do with the data.
My data is reusable. My data is findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. My data is fair.
By writing his data management plan and updating this regularly, it was very easy for Leo to make his data fair. His fair data makes it possible that researchers around the globe find, access, and reuse his data. This way, Leo's work is cited more. Leo's work is more visible and rewarded. Moreover, Leo has established collaborations with researchers beyond his network.
My data is fair!